At ICI's general membership meeting, experts painted a picture of an industry that's in a time of great transition. So how does that play out for fund board directors? Afterwards, I got some insights.
One of the first things we heard this morning was about the intense fee pressure that fund advisors are under, and about the tremendous investment they're having to make in technology. And we need to be asking about reinvestment into the business, about the steps that the advisor is taking that may not show up directly in the boardroom, but the reinvestment that they're doing, the technology improvements they're making. It'll have implications also later on if they bring on third-party administrators as we look at vendor oversight and things like that.
With this long, I suspect, kind of a long new to-do list, what else goes on to that list these days?
The challenges that distributors were facing trying to comply with the DOL rule when that was being proposed.
The fiduciary rule was out of the Department of Labor, yep.
Exactly. And even though it was never enacted, it had a pronounced impact on broker-dealers.
You also need to be aware from your position that shelf space is shrinking.
Yes, shelf space is indeed shrinking. A lot of fund companies and boards have faced dwindling distribution opportunities. We talked a little bit about how fund companies need to learn how to work outside the models. If they're not included on the shelf or included in the models, how do they build assets by positioning their funds as complements to the models? Or, alternatively, creating model portfolios of their own that distributors would consider. And that may involve embracing other people's funds in your own proprietary models. So there's a lot to be discussed, both in the boardroom and outside the boardroom by the fund company itself.